To your baptized children of God, Jesus loves you, and he loves those that you miss seeing with you at church. As we've been talking about those who have strayed away, you used to see them, they used to sit with you, whether it's friends or family or someone that you maybe don't know very well. Jesus loves those people that you miss seeing at church. And we've been thinking through what to do about that. And today we want to talk about actually starting the conversation. And I want to narrow this just to the relationship between parents and adult children. So, parents, maybe it's one of your adult children that when they turn 20, when they turn 30, whenever it was, you know, there's a year where it was the last time you saw them in church on Easter. Or maybe it's just that, you know, there's been years since you've seen them in church on any day but Easter or Christmas. I want to focus just there on parents and their children, adult children, who are no longer coming to church. Now, studies show that, you know, even among Christian households, a very small percentage of parents talk to their children about the Christian faith every day. A slightly bigger, but still very small percentage of Christian parents talk to their children about the Christian faith once a week. It may be that you, dear Christian parent, that you had the Bible opened every day, and that you prayed with them, that you were patient in instructing them. It might be that you were teaching the Word of God to them in a faithful way. If so, there's this promise, train up a child in the way he will go, and when he's old, he will not turn away from it. And if he's drifted, since you've planted those seeds, there's a really good chance that they'll be able to come back. Be confident in the Word of God that you have shared. Now, if you look back at your time when your child was in your house and you say, you know what, I'm part of that very small percentage. I am not part of that small percentage that talked about God's word every day. I'm not part of even that small but slightly bigger percentage that talked about God's word even once a week. For all intents and purposes, you wouldn't have known that God's word meant anything in our home when my kids were little. To your mom, to your dad, there's forgiveness for you. Jesus loves you. He poured out his holy precious blood for you. If you look back and see that you made it clear that other things were a much bigger priority, school, grades, earthly success, sports, dance, whatever. If you look back and you see that in your parenting, you made it clear that these things were a priority, and the Word of God can be left off always for another day, there's forgiveness for you. There's grace for you. I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Jesus loves you. And if you see that that's the case, there's a great way to start the conversation with your adult child who no longer comes to church. You can begin with an apology. Because if you do look back and you see that you made it clear that earthly success, that sports, that dance, that their fun was more important than God's word, then you have something to apologize for to them. There's the start of the conversation. You can say, I'm not surprised that you don't come to church. I'm sorry. I should have made the eternal things clearly more important in our life than the temporal things. And I want you to forgive me. And I know that you at least know why you can forgive me. Maybe we didn't, maybe Christianity, maybe religion wasn't a huge thing for us, but I know you know that Jesus died on the cross, that he died for my sins, for my failure, and being a good parent to you. And that humility, that confession, can be a great start for that conversation that can eventually make its way towards, I'd love for you to come back to church with me, because I'm starting to see how important it is. And I'm starting to see how wonderful it is just to know the forgiveness of Christ, that on Sunday morning, God's grace is poured out like a waterfall, and it's there for us. And I'm sorry, maybe you can recognize that the times that you did talk about religion, it was all about the law and about their behavior and trying to scare them into doing what is right. And maybe there's another thing that you can apologize for and say, I didn't know about the proper use of the law and the gospel, and that the point of coming to church on Sunday morning is to receive the gospel, receive the forgiveness of our sins, that we only go because we are sinners. And I want you to have the comfort that I'm starting to get now. I'm starting to realize that I didn't have when I was a younger parent. I was stressed out, I was worried, I felt ashamed and guilty, and I'm sorry. However, if you see anything in your life as a parent with your children in regards to their faith, start the conversation with that apology. Humility goes a long way. You know, don't let it be a fake apology. Your parents, your kids will read right through that. They'll see. You know, if you're not really sorry, then repent. Repent. But if you're sorry, let them see that. Let them hear that. It could be the beginning of a great conversation that leads to them sitting next to you in the pew again, and you getting to see your grandkids in the pew a lot, and your grandkids grow up with the memory of your voice singing those hymns. A memory that can be like gravity for them, pulling them back to church when one day they want to stray away. They can remember grandma's voice. They can remember grandpa singing. They can remember grandpa bowing his head in humble, reverent prayer, struggling to kneel down to receive the body and blood of the Lord. They can see that this is important to grandma and grandpa. They can start to see that this is important to mom and dad. And it'll become important to them. So parents, if you see any failure at all, start with that in your conversation with your adult kids. After that, a question and just listening. What has kept you from coming back? And then to be absolutely silent, other than some nodding along, some verbal cues that recognize, that let them know that you're listening, that you're actually paying attention. Don't look to answer even at all that day. I just want to listen. It'd be a time to maybe respond to some of those things, but if you get to a point, and especially if you have something to apologize for and you do that apology, that'll be a huge moment and probably would allow them to open up and answer the question, you know, why is it that you haven't come? And then just listen, which is such a key part to this conversation, that you listen, that you listen, that you listen. But we'll have some other videos about starting the conversation and about continuing that conversation and trying to direct it. But here, and just for parents with adult children who have strayed away, look back honestly to see if there's anything that you can apologize for. and start there. And then ask the simple question, just why is it that you haven't come back? And just listen. And then pray. Pray and pray and pray. Pray confidently, knowing that if you would get to share any of God's word, that's a powerful and effective thing, and that Jesus, in whose name you pray, he loves those people that you love. This doesn't need to be something that we're afraid of. It's something that we can have confidence in as we reach out to those who have been straying away. God be with you today.